What's up, fellas? Welcome to the garage. Well, the last time you've seen, we got the engine running, and that was real fun. But the engine wasn't performing flawlessly, and you couldn't say it was running very well either. As you could have noticed, it was hesitant to rev up, and it was running erratic sometimes.
Erratic sometimes.
You could think it was the tune's fault, and this might very well be the cause of such behavior. You know, like popping and banging while stepping on the throttle, which isn't desirable really, and is usually a sign of a lean misfire, as it's called, which is caused by a lean mixture in the cylinders. But before adjusting the fuel table, we got some basics to cover first. Well, the engine's strange behavior wasn't caused by a lean misfire. It was caused by a sync loss. As you could see in the previous video, I got a sync loss counter set up here in the software. Here it is. Now it says zero because it is unplugged. It resets every time you unplug the USB port from the ECU, or vice versa actually. Anyway, when you disconnect the USB connection between the two. So what exactly is sync loss, you ask? Well, the ECU has got many sensors feeding information into it. But the single most important one is the crankshaft position sensor. Let me quickly explain how it works. That's what it looks like. There are a couple of different variants of this sensor. This here is the VR sensor, or the virtual reluctance sensor. We'll spare all the crankshaft position sensor types for another video. So why is the crankshaft position sensor the most important one of all the sensors? Well, in order for the ECU to effectively control the engine, it has to know how fast the engine is rotating to determine when to fire spark and open the injectors. Well, in simple terms, that's how it works. I really should do an animation on this. Okay, that'll be for illustrative purposes. So how this thing works? The sensor is positioned on some trigger wheel, as it's called, or an encoder. This thing is on our engine, positioned directly on the crankshaft. As the engine spins, it obviously also spins this trigger wheel, which is solidly fixed on the crankshaft. And this wheel has got a specific number of teeth. This here is a magnetic sensor, and this trigger wheel obviously has to be ferromagnetic, made of steel, to induce the magnetic field inside the sensor. So obviously when this spins, this sensor picks up when one tooth of the trigger wheel passes it, and then sends this information to the ECU. On the base of this information, the ECU then computes how fast the crankshaft is rotating and also what's the position of the crankshaft. The ECU knows what the position is because the trigger wheels have a tooth missing. This is one way of doing it. There are many types of encoders, but the one I'm using is the same one the original Ford uses. And it's 36 minus 1. That means that this trigger wheel has got 36 teeth with one missing. So actually 35 teeth. Let me show you where the trigger wheel is located on our engine. Here, as you can see, is the trigger wheel behind this crankshaft pulley. And that's what the teeth look like. It's the same one I was showing you earlier. And this here is a special custom adapter I made for it. It's designed in a way that it allows for precise adjustment in the angular sense and also here underneath on the bottom bolt. So we're also able to change the pivot point. Let me know if you want one for yourself. So what can cause a situation like a sync loss? Well, as I explained before, This is a magnetically induced sensor. As you could imagine, this kind of sensor could be falsely triggered by electromagnetic noise. Electromagnetic noise? Where could that come from? What are we talking here? I don't hear a thing. Well, the electromagnetic noise, you won't hear it, but the sensor can, obviously. Could be induced by an alternator or starter or the ignition system or any other system that has got to do with high currents or some other systems that include electric current being switched on and off. That's due to electromagnetic collapses that happen inside such appliances. And they could mess up this sensor. This kind of noise can mess up even the signal going through a wire. That's why it's highly recommended to use a shielded wire. Or at least turn the two wires in a spiral. That also could help. Another thing that can cause sync loss issue, as we are facing here, is inadequate grounding, or wrong grounding, should we say. With the grounds, it's a bit more to it than just putting everything on a single point. Things like the ignition igniters, or the single igniter we're running on this system, can seriously mess up the crankshaft position sensor reading, hence induce sync loss. And that's exactly what was happening here. I pushed it over the limit this time, its simplicity. But, you know, it happens. You gotta try to really know. So, long story short, I've sorted out the grounds and now we got a minimal amount of sync loss. I think some of sync loss is normal when firing up the engine and shutting it off, but that's just my experience so far. Ideally, of course, you'd want zero losses. So let's go ahead and fire it up and count how many losses we get. Okay, we got a total of 5 sync losses. I think that's not ideal, but I am going to sort out the wiring, also shorten the crankshaft position sensor wire and move it far away from the igniters and everything else that's capable of inducing the noise, the electromagnetic noise I was telling you about. So I think in the end we'll be able to get it close to zero. I am speculating that some sync losses could be caused by a misfire that we will sort by tuning the engine, but that's just a quick idea that occurred in my mind. We'll see. And that's all I got for you today. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to drop us a like and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Be good!